Hey, guys, we'll open up questions for Coach Gallant.
Coach, first long road trip with Reeves and Tatar. What's your overall assessment of both players?
They were good. It's a good road trip. We had four wins, and that's the bottom line. So they were good. They both worked hard and did their jobs.
Do we have an injury entry on Riley Smith?
Riley Smith is not playing tonight. Day to day, he's getting better.
James Neal.
Same thing. James is doing real good. He skated today, so not playing tonight, but we see him in the near future.
William Carrier.
I haven't seen him today, so I haven't heard nothing yet. And you can tell me after practice, but
Subban was out there at the end, obviously looking like he's recovering good.
Yeah, he's doing good. Again, he's close. It's right around the time frame when he's supposed to come back, but day to day.
How about Luca?
Spiza. A little longer.
Hopefully not the end of the year, though.
No, I mean, she's won't be in the next week, but hopefully in the near future, like, you know, 2 or 3 weeks, I don't know.
Coach, you mentioned before you left that the 7-game homestands, the long elongated homestands, can kind of get distracted. You're looking forward to get on the road. Did you find what you were looking for? You went for one, obviously you're happy, but did you find what you're looking for in terms of that bond, getting away?
We were happy to get away. Like I said, we got new players. They get to spend some time with their teammates, so it was a good trip. I mean, every game wasn't perfect, but again, we got 8 out of 10 points, so this time of the year, you're happy to get the points. But overall, it was a great trip.
Do the standings have any impact on how quickly or how slowly you get players back on the ice if they're injured?
For me, I want to make sure the guys are ready to go. And I mean, this time of the year, you want to make sure, and the standings definitely have an effect with that, for sure. I look at it, I'm sure the trainers look at it, but at the end of the day, when the player's ready to go, you know, I'm not putting them out there, make sure they're ready.
Having played New Jersey less than 2 weeks ago, is there an advantage or disadvantage to seeing a team from the Eastern Conference so close?
Yeah, I think it's good. I mean, like you say, you only play them twice a year, so I'm happy, you know, we played them a week ago, and now we're playing them again, 5, 6 games later than the last time. So no, I think it's good. It's not an advantage for one team. It's both the same for the same team, but no big difference. But I'm glad to play them again. Like you said, we just played them, it was a good game in Jersey, and both teams played real well. So I think tonight's going to be the same thing. I think it's going to be two teams playing real good, fast hockey.
Power, he
leads the league in power play shooting percentage. And so I'm wondering what led you to putting him in the net front row? Was it tape you watched last year or just watching him in practice? Or?
No, it's Ryan
Craig did it. So you can ask Ryan that question why. But no, I mean, when power plays are going good, you leave them alone. When you got to make adjustments and try people in different situations, that's how you find out. It's just like making line combinations. I love playing the same lines every night, but when you get some injuries or guys aren't playing as well, you shift your lines up and you find some combinations that you don't expect. So, you know, Halls has done really well in that spot right now.
Can you talk about what he's done particularly well on the power play then?
Well, he shoots the puck well. He's got a lot of speed. I mean, his entries are real good on the power play. He's, you know, he's fast. He enters the goal a lot with possession, and that's important. So he's just done a good job.
With regard to the lines, feel like that combination Monday with what we'll probably see tonight?
Yeah, pretty much, yeah. No, I really liked it. I thought they played real well, and you know, there was some good compete from every line and everybody played, so I thought the line played really well. It was the best combination we had in the road trip, for sure.
So obviously we'll see that again tonight.
Yeah. Hopefully it stays like that tonight. Hopefully they play well enough, and it's going to be tough. I mean, it's always tough when you come off a long road trip, but hopefully we're ready to go.
You talk about a guy like Carpenter, he waits, you're patient, you get time. Is that the reason this team has been able to play so well? When the guys go down, you have guys who maybe weren't supposed to do anything, is actually adding things.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, that's what it is. I mean, a guy like Carpenter, I mean, like you said, we picked him up in waivers quite a while ago. He didn't play for a long time, and then all of a sudden he gets in our lineup, and he's one of those guys that you have a hard time taking out now. He's deserved every bit of it. He's played hard, he's scored big goals, he does a good job on our BK, and he plays a 200-foot game, so he's done everything we've asked from him.
Is that a good problem for you to have when everyone comes back, to have numbers in a room to maybe talk about a guy you didn't probably think you'd be talking about when the numbers come back?
Yeah, for sure. No, I mean, like I said, I didn't know much about the player when we got him, but he's done everything I've asked and more, you know. I mean, he's put a lot of pucks in the net, and he's played hard hockey, and he's played good, solid hockey. So, like I said, when you got extra bodies, it makes some tough decisions, but that's a good thing this time of the year.
I just want to make sure he doesn't feel left out. How about Lindbergh? Any update on him?
Lindbergh, I haven't heard nothing, to be honest with you, today. So him and Carey, I haven't heard nothing yet today.
Cody Eakins really elevated.
couple more questions, Coach.
The last couple games. Is it a matter of things just starting to click for him, or are you asking him to do more in the absence of other guys?
No, he's stepping up his game. I don't ask people to do anything more than they can do. Go out and play your game every day, and that's what we expect from our players. And Cody's line had a great, him and Tucky both had two goals in one of the games. They played really well, and I thought they had a great road trip. So, and then again, as soon as Tucky plays well with them, I put him up in a different line. So it's just the way it is, but Cody's played really well, I think, for sure.
Before he starts, yes.
Yeah.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
Good.